What up, everybody, and welcome to Baz on Blades. My name is Baz, and I talk about blades. Today's feature blade, another Cold Steel product. What we've got is a Cold Steel Recon 1 clip point folder. Now, the Recon 1 is available in multiple different models. You've got three size variations of the Recon 1. This is the standard version. You have a mini version and an XL version, and then also available, you have three different blade profiles. This is the clip point. You also have a spear point and a tanto version. It's a fairly wide product range within a set boundary of a design that is, no apologies, tactical folding knife. All right, I want to cover something first of all that we'll touch base on later on in this review, and that is the upcoming Cold Steel switchover on their blade steels. Now, Cold Steel used to use a lot of OS 8A, and then they switched over to Carpenter's CTS XHP, which this is an XHP version. Which is basically a stainless tool steel. And then recently, due to supply issues, they are going to change their product line. The premium steel from XHP, they're going to change over to Crucible's S35VN. Now, I'm going to touch a little bit on the steel later on in the review, but I want to say this up front. There is a YouTube channel out there. It's Cedric and Ada Gear and Outdoors. And I will put a link to this YouTube channel and a particular video in the description of this. Cedric has done many, many cutting tests on different blade steels. This channel is becoming a standard reference channel for blade steel performance because they are doing real world cutting tests. And Cedric has done a specific test with cold steel to test between the XHP knives and the upcoming S35VN knives. Again, I will put a link for that video in the description. Go over there, sub to that channel. Like I say, it is becoming a very widely used reference channel, even for all the knife reviewers on YouTube, myself included, because Cedric spends a lot of time doing these cutting tests. And I'm telling you, as much time as I spend on my reviews, I know for a fact he is spending just 10 times as much time doing these cutting tests because he's got to edit all this video. He's got great production value and is really showing what these steels can do. Now, the next thing that I want to cover, we're going to pull the packaging out here real quick on this knife. And it's just standard cold steel packaging for the Recon 1. You can see here, here's your model, 27TLC VG, and that's the clip point plain edge in OD green G10. This is pretty standard packaging, but what I want to show you on this, now this is an XHP knife. XHP was introduced into the Cold Steel line in 2015. I have a 2017 Cold Steel catalog. I don't have the 2018 yet, but I want you to look at this picture and look at the grind on this clip point. This is a hollow grind with a soft and wide plunge, and you can see that even in the illustration, they do not sharpen all the way back because there's no sharpening choil that will cover this entire plunge area. And I'll pull out another knife here real quick to show you what that looks like. And this is a Cold Steel Talawar, which is unfortunately discontinued and is my absolute favorite cold steel knife. But you can see here, as you get into the thickness in this plunge grind, you've got to stop sharpening or you would end up with just huge flare at the termination of the edge grind. There has been a change sometime during 2017 on this clip point version of the Recon 1. Previously, the mini version and the regular 4-inch version were in a hollow grind with a soft and wide plunge grind. But sometime they have changed this to match the XL version. They have changed it to a flat grind with a sharp and distinct plunge grind and an actual workable sharpening choil. So you can see that edge has been ground all the way back to termination and is even. Very, very good improvement to the 4-inch version, the most common version of the Recon 1 by Cold Steel. I was surprised to see that. I did not know that that change had been made sometime during 2017. I'm very pleased to see that change from Cold Steel. Now, this is, as I have said, an unapologetic, and I'm not the only person to say that, other reviewers do too, tactical folder from Cold Steel. This is a large knife. Let's pull out some size comparisons before we do the specs. This will give you sort of a visual reference for the specifications. So here's the Cold Steel. We've got the Paramilitary 2 from Spyderco, which is not a small knife, but is significantly shorter in both the handle and the blade length. And then I'm going to pull out a long, thin knife, and that is the Zero Tolerance 0452. This is considered a very long knife, and look at it. It is pretty much the same size as this Recon 1. This is a very large folding knife, guys. It is, by all definitions, a full-size tactical knife. Let's go ahead and knock those specs out. You are, as advertised, it's a 4-inch blade. I measured it at 3 7/8 inch. That's about slightly less than 10 centimeters. The blade stock thickness is 133 thousandths of an inch, or 3.36 millimeters. Blade width, 1.27 inches, or 32.3 millimeters. Your handle length, 5 3/8 of an inch, or 13.5 centimeters. Handle thickness, 507 thousandths of an inch, or 12.9 millimeters. Handle width at the pivot here is 1.45 inches or 36.87 millimeters. You're closed with 1.81 inches or 46.1 millimeters. Overall length, 9 1/4 inches or 23.5 centimeters. Stop pin diameter, 198 thousandths of an inch or 5 millimeters. Behind the edge thickness, I averaged it on three different points and got about 25 to 27 thousandths of an inch or 0.65 millimeters. Your handle to blade ratio, a respectable 0.72, and your weight, 5.26 ounces or 149 grams. And I will say this about the weight, it does not feel heavy in the hand. It does not feel heavy in the hand at 5.26 ounces or 149 grams because it is such a big knife that is actually a fairly light weight. All right, let's go ahead to our blade steel. Again, this is one of the last of the production runs in CTS XHP, which is an American-made steel from Carpenter. Carpenter is concentrating more on industrial supply, and it's getting harder and harder to get this steel in the batch sizes that these knife manufacturers need. It's more of a steel for like tool and die industry and you know, industrial use. It is, by all accounts, I honestly consider it a stainless tool steel. It is like a super hard version of 440C or a stainless version of D2. It's actually the best of both of these steels combined. Extended cutting performance and extended corrosion resistance. You're looking at 1.6% carbon content, 16% chromium, and 0.45% vanadium. Typically, you'll see this steel rock weld in the 60 to 62 rock weld range. With that, you get excellent edge retention, wear resistance, very good impact resistance or toughness, and very good corrosion resistance. There's a reason CTS XHP has been such a popular steel and such a success with cold steel. It is a very, very good performing steel at the upper range of modern knife steels. All right, into your handle. A lot of cold steel's modern G10 builds, what you've got is a couple of thick G10 slabs here. This is very coarse G10. It is the coarsest surface texture G10 that cold steel uses. And it is very grippy, guys. It is thick slabs, very strong. It is structurally rigid and a very good base or foundation for the triad lock, arguably the strongest lock on the folding blade market, guys. But you've got G10 here, stainless small parts that are in black finish. The finish on the blade is in DLC, diamond-like carbon. And then on all the rest of it, it is a Teflon coating. You do have a stamped steel pocket clip. And the packaging does come with a second pocket clip with the opposite radius for left-hand tip-up carry. So it is ambidextrous for tip-up carry. Beyond that, you do have a hard-coat anodized aluminum backspacer here that is also pretty universal across this type of build with cold steel, not only in the Recon 1, in the American Lawman, and then in the Talwar, which I have on hand, also the same thing. In fact, you can see it is aluminum here, and I carry this knife a lot. I love it so much, but it is a hard coat anodized, and it will wear off. All right. You know what? So materials, it's pretty much its typical cold steel. The Recon 1 has not changed much over the last generation or so. As far as materials go, it is very stoutly built. Those are very thick G10 slabs, and this knife feels extremely solid in the hand. Now, fit and finish. We'll go back to the blade. We're going to look at this coating first. Now, I've been using this knife for a week now, and there is absolutely zero wear on this coating. DLC is not like the old Teflon coating. DLC is understood to be one of the two toughest coatings on the market, the other one being like a PVD type of coating. And these very high-end coatings actually bind with the steel on a molecular level on the surface. The coating fuses with the surface of the steel, and it is basically sort of a ceramic type of coating that is nearly as hard as diamond. The coating itself is harder than the steel that it has merged with. It will take a lot of damage. It will wear very slowly. The only thing that on cold steel, they do give sort of a high satin finish to this blade steel before they apply the coating. And since it is such a thin coating, you get sort of a very high satin black. And it does, it just shows fingerprints readily, guys. So you got to take that into account, but it is a great coating. The grinds on this, you've got a very high flat grind. It is a saber grind. You do have a shallow swedge grind on the clip of the clip point. You do have a very pointy and very piercing, you can see instantly pierces with little to no pressure point. A very, very good clip point blade design. Very slicey in that high flat grind. Very pointy. Good blade coating. The Recon 1 font and marking on the front actually fits this knife. Then you've got on the back your cold steel marking, your CTS XHP steel type, and made in Taiwan. This does use the two-piece thumb stud system that can be changed out. The offside has a Phillips head or a flathead screw slot in it. Sorry, guys. In that shorter offside, so you can take it off and switch it over for a left-hand carry. And since you do have a back lock, the triad lock, it is a pretty much ambidextrous knife in combination with the changeable pocket clip. That is a great thing about that triad lock. Fit and finish on the handle. Let's take a very close look, guys, at the machining here on the handle on the G10. You do have a very wide chamfer and radius around the edge with exemplary and extremely clean machining, guys. G10 machines and grinds so well, it is easy to do exact machining and grinding on. This is very well done. Everything is fit very well. There's no gaps. There's no sharp corner. I mean, there's nothing. Even a corner that looks like it should be sharp is not, guys. It is softened on the inside edge just enough to keep it from being sharp. It's just crisp around the edge. And everything is so well done. The finish on all the small hardware, including the triad lock system hardware, is all even and matches very well. The blackness, again, you know, you got dual pocket clip system for right or left hand carry. And it is a Teflon finish on the pocket clip and small parts, so it will wear. You can see it's starting to chip around here. So that is not the same finish as the blade. It is just the fit and finish, guys. Awesome. Awesome, guys. I paid $87 for this knife. $87 for a 4-inch blade in XHP with this heavier build and absolutely the strongest locking system on the market is a steal as far as I'm concerned, even for a product made in Taiwan. Now, let's go on to the action. And the first thing I want to show you is unlocking this thing. Okay, that's pretty doggone good action, guys. It is very smooth opening up. It is drop down closing. It's not like a bearing pivot, but it is a very good phosphor bronze pivot. The lock actually for a triad lock is not too bad. It's a little easier to work than the more compact version that's on the American Lawman as far as the pressure you have to put down. If you will listen very closely, there is just a little, it's not lock stick. I'm going to tell you exactly what it feels like. It feels like the trigger on a 1911 pistol when it breaks. You'll hear that described as glass rod breakage. And that's what that feels like. It's just a tick where it breaks loose there, guys. And then the knife, the blade is just so smooth in the action. This is not the type of knife that you're going to sit around and flick around as a fidget toy. It can be flicked open, but it does take a little bit of technique because of the thumb studs having to get on the thumb stud real good. It's more of just a manual roll it open type of knife, and it's very acceptable with that because what you're looking at is a strong lockup for a hard use knife. And I believe that this knife was tested, the lock on it was tested by Cold Steel and Andrew Demko, and I'm pretty sure that they hung like a school bus off of it. It's like 16 million pounds of pressure that it took. In fact, they were testing it, and it broke all the testing equipment and cracked the foundation of the building while they were testing it, and the lock held up. That's how strong a triad lock is. Okay, a little bit of exaggeration, but seriously, it is extremely strong. It's not the type of lock you'll play around with, but extremely strong. This knife is very smooth. It is perfectly centered up, guys. I have not had to, listen to that lockup, guys. It is just, I love the sound of a triad lock locking up more than any other type of knife or lock system. There's knives that I will grab that are ball bearing pivot and they're ultra smooth and they're just works of art. And then there's this knife, which is an ultimate hard use, quote unquote, tactical folder. And that's what you get. All right, let's go to ergos and utility. We will start with the utility use of this clip point blade with very high flat grind. It is a very slicey. The 25 to 27 thousandths behind the edge thickness on this is due more to sort of a short edge grind than it is to a thick blade. When I resharpen this knife, if I ever have to, I will thin that out a little bit, and I guarantee this is going to turn into a slicing machine. A machine, guys, because it already is just, it slices like crazy. And I'm going to say, of the four cold steel folders that I have in my personal collection, every one of them came with as sharp or sharper than anything else edge that I've ever found in a production knife. And this Talwar, I have been carrying this for a year and using it. I'm wearing the finish off of it, guys. It's never been resharpened. It's still got the factory edge. It will still shave hair. It is crazy. I'm going to miss XHP in these blades, even though S35VN is one of my favorite steels. I'm going to miss this XHP because it has got great edge retention. But you've got this great clip point blade here. You've got a nice length of flat straight edge, great belly here, very pointy clip point point here that is not too awful thin, okay? It's still substantial enough to use. You could bore with it. I mean, you've got great slicing capability. Again, kudos to Cold Steel on this excellent sharpening notch here, this small choil. Your thumb studs are back far enough away. They're not in the way of the base of the cutting edge or resharpening, so you're not going to have to remove them. You've got this nice flat section here. So if you're using a clamp system like a Lansky or a KME, something like that, easy to clamp up, keep it straight, and get ready to sharpen. I love this sort of subtle swedge on the clip here, just enough to thin it down, but not enough to where it's not just for style. It's more of a functional swedge, I believe. All right, there's no jimping on the back of this blade, so jimping fanatics beware. But let's look at this handle. This is one of the most ergonomic handle designs I've ever seen in a tactical folder. It is an excellent, excellent design. Let's look at it in the hand. You've got two finger choils here, which typically I would shy away from as I prefer a single choil. But it works very well for my medium-sized hands. You can see you've got plenty of room left on the handle right here for large-sized hands. These are bigger choils. I think this handle, as far as size and overall design, is great for any size of hand, from small to extra large. You know, the handle length is 5 3/8 inches, and your grip surface here is, you know what, guys, it's probably 4 3/4 inches at least. Now, you may look at this pivot area and think, this is a little bulky, and there's a lot of space that a forward choil could have been put here, but look at this. If I wanted to choke up on this knife, I've got this nice flat right here, and then I've got an extension of flat before the sharpening choil at the ricasso area of the blade here at the base of the blade. I can actually choke up on this comfortably. This is a nice, wide, softly radiused area here, and it works pretty much just as well as a sharpening choil. If I need to get a little closer, I can get down in this little recess right here on the flat in the ricasso area of the blade, and I can get right up. I mean, look at that closely, guys. I am right up. I'm pressing hard to press skin down, and I'm still not touching that edge. That is nearly as good as a forward choil for sort of a push cut type of cut. That's actually very good, guys. And again, you've got deep finger choils here for retention. That's one of the reasons I say you don't really need any jimping on the blade. You do have this jimping on the back of the handle in this sort of concaved up into a semi-thumb ramp here. But it does not go across the lock mechanism, obviously, because they want that mechanism to be strong. They don't want to take those big divots out of it. It's not really useful. If you press real hard, you can feel it, but you can see it doesn't really stop my thumb from sliding, but I've got this nice large concaved area and ramp area here. It feels very comfortable. It is perfectly placed in conjunction with the forward finger choil. It is a very locked in sort of feel, guys, for forward and reverse cutting. I do not feel like I'm ever going to slip on that. This handle is wide open enough to where you can use it in a reverse grip easily. You fall right in. Let's see if we can see this. Right in again to those two choils, and then the rest of that handle is wide open with, again, plenty of space for extra large hands. You could use the butt end as an impact device because you've got this full aluminum backspacer here in that thick G10. An excellent handle design, very ergonomic, combined with a very utilitarian, very slicey clip point blade. I think ergos and utility are a huge, huge win on this knife. Now, that said, for those of you that want me to talk about this Course G10, I recently did a video on modifying this knife, the Course G10 pocket clip issue. I will put a link for that in the description, and you can check that out. It is not a big deal. This knife has been modified. You can't even tell, and it goes out in and out of the pocket very easy. It's not going to shred my pocket up now, but this grippy G10, I've still got the characteristic of this G10, that surface texture that I really, really love. I love this G10. As much as I like the look of a smooth machine G10 and sort of the wood grain look it takes on, I also love this Course G10. All right, so what does Baz on Blades think about the Cold Steel Recon 1 4-inch in clip point blade configuration? Baz on Blade loves this knife. This has become my go-to hard use knife. Cold Steel, a company that I used to not care much for because I let my opinion of their marketing get in the way of actually giving their products a chance. Cold Steel has really impressed me in the last couple of years. First, I added in the Talwar 4-inch, immediately went and got a second one of those. Then the next thing you know, I've got the American Lawman for my everyday carry kit, and now I've got this Recon 1, and hands down, out of my collection, it's going to become my hard use folder. That's just all there is to it. So Baz on Blades is going to heartily recommend the Recon 1. I like it in this clip point. I also like the spear point, although I believe that it is still in the hollow grind with the incomplete sharpening choil. So the edge grind cannot go all the way to termination. So keep that in mind, and the spear point is a little thicker in the tip. If you're looking for tip strength, then the spear point may be a little bit better, just, you know, a little bit different in a hollow grind rather than a flat grind. But I'm going to tell you what, guys, this is just, it's such a good design, and this video is running long. I apologize for that. I'm going to go ahead and cut it off. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch one of my videos. God bless all of you, and we will talk to you again.